अस्सलाम
अस्सलाम वालेकुम सर, गुड इवनिंग।
वालेकुम, गुड इवनिंग।
गुड इवनिंग सर।
हाउ आर यू एवरीबॉडी?
नाइस सर,
नाइस।
अलहमदुलिल्लाह।
Okay, today, okay, all students are available. How are you, everybody? All are fine?
Fine, yes, sir.
That's good.
Fine, sir.
Okay. So today I have to start new briefing. What is topic do you have in your record? Knowledge? You have to confirm me now what is the, I should start briefing a new topic today. Well, next topic, do you have it? Do you have in your register, I noted you, all topics? 10 topics. That what today?
It's knowledge, sir.
Knowledge is today. Okay. I start briefing on knowledge today. Number 4 briefing, I think so. Is it? Number 4 or number 5?
4, sir.
Number 4. Knowledge.
Sam se pooch, subah se entry kis mein thi, jaldi jao, time nahi hai.
Right, main points. Main points. Definition, importance, types or kinds, problems, benefits, suggestions, and then my last point of view. You have to note all these main points regarding knowledge. Briefing number 4. Did you note anybody?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
First of all, please keep your mic on silent. First of all, definition. Second, importance, then types or kinds, then problems, then benefits, then suggestions, and in the end point of view. Let us start definition of knowledge. What is knowledge? Somebody asks you. Knowledge means if somebody has any information, somebody knows about anything, somebody has any knowledge, somebody has any information or any knowledge, and somebody is conscious about anything, and if somebody is aware about anything, so it is called knowledge. Simple definition of knowledge: if somebody knows about anything, it is called knowledge. Somebody has any information is called knowledge. That is simple definition of knowledge. Second point, importance. Knowledge has great importance in the lives of all human beings in the world. Nobody can deny the importance of knowledge. According to teachings of Islam, knowledge or education is obligatory for every Muslim. In all religions, it is forced by Creator that knowledge is important. Knowledge has great importance. Nobody can survive without knowledge in the world. Somebody is illiterate, he can tell you what is the importance of knowledge. Because any illiterate person or any uneducated person faces major and main problems in the world in the absence of education or knowledge. Instead of somebody has, if somebody is literate or well educated, instead of he has not any information about anything, so somebody can cheat him easily. So he also acts like illiterate person or uneducated person. If somebody has not knowledge about anything, so he is equal to illiterate person or uneducated person. In other words, did you understand now what I said now? It's the importance of knowledge. But if somebody is literate or educated, he is much better than illiterate person or uneducated person. Knowledge has great importance in our lives. Knowledge plays major role in our lives. Knowledge is most important for our lives. And I tell you importance of knowledge. It looks like that why we are alive, because soul is inside our body, so we are alive. Same here, for our survival in the world, knowledge has same importance for us like soul inside our body. Is the importance of knowledge. Third point, types or kinds of knowledge. There are three main types or kinds of knowledge. First of all, theory. What is theory? Theory means all reading material, all study material is called theory.
So later then.
We have studied to theory. First and main source of knowledge is theory. We have to study to theory. It is main source of knowledge. From nursery to masters, we have to study to theory. We study two different books. We read two different books. And we have to get knowledge by study or by reading. Theory is the fundamental source of knowledge. It is a basic source of knowledge. Now, second source of knowledge, what is that? Practical. What is practical? We have to apply theory as a practical. And we have to learn different skills. We have to apply theory in practicals. The other source of knowledge is practical. Practical. What is practical now? Practical, meaning of practical. We have to apply theory in practical. any manual work. Manual. Is practical, manual work. You know that I talk about metric, I talk about syllabus subjects, I talk about science subjects in metric, biology, physics, and chemistry. We do practical, we have to apply theory in practical. I have to talk about different skills. All languages, including spoken English language, are source of knowledge or part of knowledge. We have to learn these skills. First of all, we took a start from theory. Same here, I give you example here regarding this skill. You have to learn theory. What is theory? Grammar. Then you have to apply theory in practical, in language. You have to apply theory. And you have to learn skill. As a practical, we have to apply theory in this skill. All languages are part of practical. Most people have to get knowledge about different skills. There are different skills in the world. All languages, all computer courses, driving skill, carpenter. If somebody wants to make carpenter, you have to learn skill of carpenter. If somebody wants to make electrician, he have to learn as a skill. Electrician course, he have to complete. Same here, if somebody wants to make draftman, he have to learn the skill of draftman. If somebody wants to make, you know, hardware, you know, expert, so he have to learn the hardware skill. Same here in auto workshops, somebody wants to make mechanic, he have to learn mechanical skill. Even I tell you one thing for, practically I tell you one thing, how to make tea. It is also skill, how to make tea. Most people can't make tea, but they can take tea, but they can't, you know, they can't make tea. It also skill. I mean to say, since when we don't practical, we can't learn anything. We can't have proper grip on knowledge. Now I tell you about that. Mostly people are illiterate, but those people are expert in practicals in different skills. But there is problem. Problem is here because those people, their base is not there. Those people are baseless. Only they have to copy to other person and they have to learn this skill. It is not a proper foundation. Baseless. Baseless means without foundation. No foundation. Without foundation. Baseless means without foundation. It looks like that something is in the air, something in the air between sky and earth. But those people are expert in their skills, but they don't know how it happened, because those people are unconscious about theory. It is the main reason behind. Those people can't satisfy the other person. If somebody asks you how you can repair the car, if somebody asks from auto mechanic, any literate person asks him, okay, can you tell me the names of these tools in English? Okay, but and how to use, they can't tell you. So I told you basic thing of knowledge is theory. On the base of theory, on the base of it is fundamental thing now. Theory is a basic thing. Then we can go ahead, we can move ahead. If you have to make any building, first of all, we need foundation. Without foundation, without base, we can't make any building. It is common sense. Foundation, if we have to make foundation, we go in the depth of the ground and we why we go in the depth of the earth, depth of the ground, because we want it, that building should be strong. It is the main reason behind. If base is weak, automatically, Allah forbid, as a result of earthquake, building will fall down. Same here. Third part of knowledge is experience. Experience. We have to get knowledge by experience. It is the third type of knowledge, third source of knowledge. Third source of knowledge is experience. We have to get knowledge by experience. There are three pillars of knowledge. Most people have to get knowledge by three main pillars. First of all, theory, then practical, then experience. People have to apply theory and practical and then get experience. People have to belong from different classes in the society. Just three main sources. People have to get knowledge just by three main sources. Nobody can say that there is four source of knowledge. No, it is impossible. As I told you, everybody have to start from theory regarding knowledge. You know that I talk about any kid. He have to take start of education from nursery. So foundation of knowledge is theory. Then, now any kid becomes young. So he gets education from college. Then he goes to university. Then during this time, he have to, he starts different practicals in higher education. Then after completion of education, after complete to education, he have to get experience. So he goes to practical life. Then he gets knowledge from three sources. He have to get knowledge by three main sources: theory, practical, and experience. There are numberless types of theories. There are numberless types of skills. There are numberless types of practicals. There are numberless types of experiences in the world. So these are three main pillars to get knowledge. Nobody can deny the importance of anyone. Nobody can say that I am perfect without theory. Nobody can say, I am perfect without theory and practical. I am perfect. Nobody can say. Somebody can say, I am perfect since when he has not complete information about theory. Somebody has complete information about theory, and he will be successful, in practical. And automatically, if somebody has strong grip in theory and practical, most probably and certainly, he will be successful person. Because by help of a strong theory and strong practical, he will get extraordinary experience, and he will make as a successful person in the society. I told you about three main types or kinds of knowledge. First of all, theory. Other one, practical, and third one, experience. People are engaged in different jobs. On what basis people are successful in their jobs now? On the basis of theory and practical. If somebody, gets theory, but theory is different than practical, I tell you one thing. Theory is separate knowledge, and practical is separate knowledge. Many things we don't apply in our practical life. We have to apply 50% things in practical life, 50% things we don't apply in practical life. But knowledge is knowledge. Somebody can use his knowledge anywhere. Knowledge, gives benefit anytime during life. Now I tell you about, how people have to get experience. If people have to start their practical life, people have to start any job. In offices, people have to face many problems. So gradually people have to learn different things. And after some time, a long time, people have to reach good post or good job. But genius people have to approach easily. But there are different types of people. Some people are genius, some people are not so genius, some people are inefficient, some people can't pick anything. So if somebody can't pick anything, so person will be unsuccessful, or he will face many failures in practical life. Most probably his theory will be weak, his practical will be weak. Automatically a person can't get success in practical life. Genius person have to get extraordinary success in practical life. Genius. Why genius people have to get success, extraordinary success in practical lives? Because their theory and practical is perfect. This is the main reason behind now. They have much self-confidence. They have much confidence. It is the main reason behind now. It is the main reason behind genius people have to reach to a key post. And very soon, those people have to make officers in short time. Problems. Next point, problems. What problems people have to face regarding knowledge? Why most people can't get much knowledge? What is the reason behind now? First of all, due to illiteracy. And why most people are illiterate? Because people have not proper facilities of education. On the other hand, fee is so expensive, fee is so much, so most people can't afford the fee in schools, in colleges, and in the universities, and in private sector academies and institutes. Basic problem. Then other problem, people have to discourage to other people. No encouragement in our society. People have to discourage to people, if somebody is genius, people don't want that person have to get success or promotion. Due to discouragement, mostly people are disappointed and discouraged. And we have to lose our talent in this way. Further problems, the environment problem, most people don't get knowledge by positive sources. Most people are engaged to use internet for negative purposes. Negative purposes. People are kill their time. People kill their time in negative activities. People have to waste their time. People kill their time in the negative activities due to environment. Most people can't get much knowledge and information because people kill their time. Further problems, I have to tell you, as I told you, people have to discourage, mostly people discourage to other people, but they, most people are selfish. They wanted that concerned person have to get success, and his friend and his cousin don't get the success in practical life. Leg pulling is very common in our society. Honest people and hardworking people and talented people are discouraged in our society. It is not only in Pakistan, in all over the world, especially I focus to Asian countries. But I admire to European countries, their talent is appreciated. Admire. Admire. Next, benefits. What benefits we have to get by knowledge? First of all, if somebody has much knowledge or extraordinary knowledge, if somebody has extraordinary knowledge, so certainly person will get extraordinary success in practical life, because Allah helps to deserve person. Deserve person. Further benefits, by extraordinary knowledge, people have to fulfill their dreams, people have to fulfill their desires, people have to achieve their goals, people have to achieve their targets, people have to get prosperity, people can spend lives with full joy, people have to enjoy their lives by extraordinary knowledge, and people have to get the status in the society. People have to make a role model by extraordinary knowledge. People have to make exemplary in the society by extraordinary knowledge. People can make healthy and wealthy by extraordinary knowledge. People have to get respect everywhere by extraordinary knowledge. People have to make people can make their lives like heaven. People can get the success in this world and after and in other world after their death. People can, if people have to guide to somebody, so people can do many virtues. People can do good deeds. These are benefits. Number six, suggestions. How we can improve our knowledge? How we can increase our knowledge? How we can make successful? First of all, we should not kill our time. First of all, we should not study daily. We should study daily. We should not kill our time. We need planning for our lives. We have to make keen observer. We have to learn different skills. First of all, we should learn to spoken English language skill. Then we have to learn computer skills. It is the need of time. Nowadays, that person is successful in all over the world. If somebody is expert in English language and somebody is expert in computer courses, these are two basic things are obligatory for extraordinary success in the world. Then we have to learn different skills. We have to learn different languages after spoken English language. But knowledge is very precious. We have to learn other skills like shorthand skill. We have to learn tapping skill. We have to even if we have to learn anything, we should not think about it that it is minor skill. Even we should learn how to repair the car. We should learn how to make tea. We should learn how to repair to make furniture. We have to learn, you know, electrician course, electrician skill. We have to learn teaching skill. So I mean to say, any person should not kill his time. Knowledge is very precious. And I give you guarantee that if you have any knowledge, you have to get benefit anytime. Maybe in your interviews, if you go for an interview for job for the post of officer, so if you have any knowledge, so that knowledge will help you in your interviews. So my suggestion that if you want extraordinary success in this world, then basic thing that you should complete your masters. I will prefer you should master in English literature. Then you have to learn English language by all means. Also, if you do masters in English literature, automatically you will improve your language. You will improve your spelling. You will improve your vocabulary. And easily you can complete your language, spoken English language course, basic and advanced, easily. On the other hand, you have to learn basic and advanced computer courses. I give you guarantee. It is the, you know, knowledge is very precious about anything. But nowadays, it is trend. You have to prefer this trend. You should adopt this trend if you have to make successful person in the society. If you want get success, everybody, if you want respect everywhere, then you have to act on my instructions, my suggestions. In the end, my point of view, knowledge is key of treasure. The knowledge is the key of treasure. This is my point of view. The knowledge is the key of treasure. I have to close my briefing on knowledge here. Yes, students. Did you listen my briefing carefully?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Did you? Okay, good. Did you pick nicely?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So you know that it is the best way of practice. You have to fresh up these things in your mind, and you have 7 points, or you have 7 points on whiteboard, and all question can make in all main points you can change in the questions. What is the definition of knowledge? Why knowledge has great importance? How many types of kinds of knowledge? What problems we have to face regarding knowledge? What benefits we have to enjoy by knowledge? What are suggestions regarding knowledge? And in the end, what is point of view? Just you have to all main points you can change in the questions automatically. You can prepare well. Okay, your knowledge, it is also knowledge. You have to find knowledge inside the knowledge. These also, you know, 7 points are, you know, part of knowledge. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Did you get my point? What I said now. So I tell you one thing, that last time, you know, that Fazlur Rahman asked me this question, sir, give us a golden suggestion how we can improve our language. I told him that you all colleagues, you have to discuss in English about anything. You have to act on this suggestion. Automatically, you can enjoy this language, and you can improve rapidly, quickly, or fastly in this way. And you have to talk in English like Urdu. That time is not so far. Did you get my point now?
Yes, sir.
I need your commitment. Will you follow my instruction? Zain.
Yes, sir.
Zubair.
Yes, sir.
Sajjad, Tariq.
Yes.
Tariq.
Yes, sir. Yes.
And Fazlur Rahman. Yes.
Yes, sir.
Everybody, Fazlur Rahman, you know, I appreciate you. You asked me good question. Yes. Okay.
Yes. Yes.
Thank you, sir.
And you have to all students. You have to talk in English about any topic, but don't discourage to other person. If you want get success, you have to encourage to each other. You need teamwork, all of you. Okay. It's right, also sir. Suggestion how you can get extraordinary knowledge. Got it now? It is way towards success. Do you understand?
Right, sir. Yes, sir.
Good.
Yes, sir.
Good. And I will notice you. Maybe as a tout, I can check you. Do you talk in Urdu or English? Okay. Do you understand what I said now?
Okay.
Tout.
Sir.
I can check you as a tout. T-O-U-T. Tout. Okay, so